This video will show Alfresco Activiti. It'll show how to create a workflow using the step editor and then how users interact with that workflow during its lifecycle. First off, we're going to create a new process. This process is going to be for handling warranty claims for faulty parts. I'm going to use the step editor. This will guide me through the process of creating a new model. I give my process model a name and also a description so other people know what it's for. I want my process to start by a user completing a form. I don't have a form, so I'm going to create one. Again, we give the form a name and a description. Now I can design my form by just simply dragging components from the left-hand side onto my form. First one is going to be the customer name. What's the name of the customer that's returned the faulty part? I may want to upload documents as part of this process. So I've got an upload field, and this is where we're going to load faulty reports. I've continued to add a few more fields to my form, and we'll just save that away. I process through now the step editor creating new steps. So I've added in a component information step and a faulty part inspection step. The next thing I want to do is actually publish content to Alfresco. Any documents that get associated with this process will be saved inside of Alfresco. I'm going to select where to save it in Alfresco. And I want to create a separate folder purely for this claim. And I'm going to base that on a customer name. The next thing I want to do is have a decision step. So the outcome of my process could be two things. A, we're going to replace a part under warranty. It's failed. Or B, the customer's actually use the part improperly. They haven't used it correctly. And I want this to be based on a form outcome. So from the inspection, we can then say if it equals improper usage, then we're going to go down this path. And then the next step then would be to inform the customer that they've used the part incorrectly, and then tell them how they should be using the part in the future. So that's created my process. I want to bundle it up into a process app. And this is a way of putting together one or more process definitions into a process app that I can publish and allow anybody in my organization to use. I'm going to give it a unique icon, change the color, and I'm going to include my new process definition, my model, as part of this process app. You know, save that away and then just publish that. And that lets anybody in the organization use this if they need to. I can add it to my homepage. Just deploy my new process app. So let's define my process. Now I can start those. Perhaps I've received a faulty part. So I'm going to create a new process. Here's my warranty claim. The first thing we need to do is complete some of that information associated with the new part. So we've got a part from Globex International. They've sent us a link via Google Docs to a fault report, so we can add that to the process. We've received the part. We've got a description of what the failure was. So I've now started that process. That moves it on to the next stage. If I now log in as Fiona, Fiona goes to her tasks. She hasn't got anything, but she's part of the quality assurance group, and she can see that there's a step waiting to be claimed, so she can claim that task. Here you can see the fault reports, you can see the customer information, the part number, the batch number and everything. Now she's not quite sure whether that there's a problem here, so she can step out of that process and actually invite somebody else to collaborate with her. So she's going to send this to Jeremy and she's going to add a comment saying, Jeremy, can you please look at this? I think the problem is that they've used the wrong settings. They've even tightened a bolt or something. So this is stepping out of my process to involve other people, to collaborate with those people as part of this process. Jeremy's logged in. He's seen the comments and he's responded saying, yes, the customer's used the wrong torque setting. And he's uploaded a document to give me some technical specifications for the part in question. So now Fiona can review this. She can see all the technical details and say, yep, I can see that they've over tightened. So it is incorrect usage. So she's going to go back to the form. She's completed a fault report, an inspection report. She saved that in Alfresco. So she's going to attach that from Alfresco to this process. And she's going to complete it with a summary of what her findings, and then just say report improper usage. If we go back now to Bruce, who initiated this process, when he goes and sees his tasks, he's got a task from Fiona to complete. He can review the complete process, so he can see all the documents that have been created, all the activity that's gone on. And then he can say, yeah, I can see I need to complete this by informing the customer. And he marks that as complete. If we just quickly flip over to Alfresco, remember we said we were going to save all the documents. I can see that I've got a Globex International folder automatically created by Activiti. And I can see the two documents that were captured as part of that process.